Dimitrios Magriplis walked into Restaurant Depot on November 3, 2011 in good health with a positive outlook on life. In a moment, his physical and mental well-being were permanently altered when a 200-pound pallet full of merchandise was pushed on top of him from 20 feet in the air. Mr. Magriplis was struck in the head and lost consciousness. When he awoke, he realized that the force of the trauma had traveled all the way down to his right leg, causing a severe fracture and dislocation of his ankle.
All I remember is just waking up and just being in extreme agonizing pain, not knowing what had happened to me.
He was transported to Yale New Haven Hospital for a course of treatment that continues to this day. This never had to happen. An investigation by OSHA into the cause of this incident revealed that a box of brooms had not been secured to a pallet. This box was then pushed by the pallet that was being loaded onto shelving into the pallet that fell onto Mr. Magriplis. Mr. Magriplis and the Restaurant Depot employee with him were within inches of being crushed to death. OSHA fined Restaurant Depot $27,500 for violating federal regulations. The fine was significant, as Restaurant Depot had been cited for this same violation of federal regulations in April of 2009. In this case, Restaurant Depot admits the box should have been secured to the pallet. Even after the citations by OSHA, Restaurant Depot reported a series of similar accidents, some with causes and outcomes eerily similar to the November 3, 2011 accident. It is clear that this entire tragedy could have been avoided if Restaurant Depot had followed simple safety rules that have become the industry standard for pallet manipulation.